On February 19, 1942, the President of the United States, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, signed Executive Order 9066, which ordered all Japanese Americans on the West Coast, approximately 120,000 of us, to be imprisoned with no charges. In April, I turned 5 years old, and a few weeks after my fifth birthday, my parents got me up very early one morning, together with my brother, a year younger, and my sister, not quite a year old. And they dressed us hurriedly, and my brother and I were told to wait in the living room while they did some last-minute packing back in the bedroom. We were loaded onto trucks with other Japanese-American families that had been gathered and driven over to Santa Anita Racetrack. And there we were unloaded and herded over to the stable area. We were herded again, put on buses, taken to Union Station, and loaded on trains with armed guards at both ends of each car and transported two-thirds of the way across the country to the swamps of Arkansas. And so my father waded out into that muck and found it a very interestingly shaped snaking of the root and sawed it off, brought it back, boiled it in an oil drum, and peeled the barks off to reveal a beautiful piece of Mother Nature sculpture. And he had it in our barrack, and we carried it with us when we were transferred to another camp. When we came out of camp, my mother kept it, or my father kept it in our living room, and I grew up watching it and thinking how beautiful Mother Nature can craft the roots of trees. But when he passed, it disappeared. I went to visit my mother and it wasn't there. So I said, "Mama, where's Daddy's swamp root?" And she said it reminded her too much of the imprisonment, and she put it back in the garage. I went into the garage, dug it out, and brought it back, and it's here at my home. It's a beautiful work of nature, but it's also what my father saw in a common, you know, we saw those roots all over, but he thought there was beauty there, and he boiled it and revealed that beauty. So even imprisoned behind those barbed wire fences, I think part of resilience isn't all just teeth-gritting strength and resilience, but also part of resilience is finding joy, finding beauty, finding love. And we saw that happen in another form. Humanities are important because they make us human. I mean, it's our better angels. We are capable of some horrific things. I mean, when you look at human history, it's a history of wars, history of wars fought in the name of religion, and horrific things have been done in those wars. We're capable of that. And it's the humanities that remind us that we are better than that. We are human, meaning that we can have compassionate relationships with each other, to love each other, to try to make our society better, to make a contribution to a better world.